climbing again.
Down there?
Well, I'm not unless you're sitting
there. Up here, maybe.
Shit. Oh, I'm off the edge.
A wild colonial boy, Jack Doolin was his name. Of poor but honest parents, he was born near Castlemaine. He was his father's only son and his mother's pride and joy. So dearly did his parents love their wild colonial boy.
The track sort of stops up here, get down into a big valley.
Barely 16 years of age, he first began to roam and found Australia's sunny shores and called it his true home. He robbed the wealthy squatters their assets to destroy. A terror to the rich ones was the wild colonial boy. Back in 1861 began his wild career. With a head that knew no danger and a heart that held no fear, he held the mudgy mail coach up and he shot Judge McAvoy. A curse to every copper was the wild colonial boy. Later on that very day, as Jackie rode along, listening to the kookaburra's pleasant laughing song, he spied three mounted troopers, Kelly, Davis, and Fitzroy, with a warrant for the of the wild colonial boy. Surrender now, Jack Doolin, for you see we're 3-1. Surrender now in the Queen's high name, or your living days are done. Jack drew two pistols from his belt and he waved them proud and high. How fight but not surrender, cried the wild colonial boy. Jack fired once at Kelly, brought him to the ground. Then turning around from Davis' gun, received his mortal wound. A bullet pierced his proud young heart from the pistol of Fitzroy. And that's the way they captured him, the wild colonial boy. Yes, that's the way they captured him. freedom, the wild colonial boy.